sponsored by Sprite. It's the 2K Sports pregame show.
Hello again, everybody. I'm Ernie Johnson, along with Shaquille O'Neal on 2K Sports, and the NBA season is about to begin. In this game, we'll see the Atlanta Hawks going up against the Toronto Raptors at Air Canada Center. For Toronto, what an atmosphere they'll be playing in tonight. Opening night, hometown fans ready to go wild as they go after that first win. Boy, the Hawks have some big bodies along that front line, Shaq. How do you keep them from dominating the paint?
Well, you have to collapse down. You got to show double. You got to be real aggressive, especially on your rotations. You can't let them get too deep inside on you, Ernie.
Truer words never spoken. Let's turn it over to Kevin Harlan.
Welcome, everyone, to a brand new season of NBA basketball. I'm sure you're as excited as all of us are here at 2K Sports. This is Kevin Harlan with my partners, Clark Kellogg and Steve Kerr, Doris Burke on the sideline, as we get ready to start the season in style. So Atlanta will get the first possession. All fueled up and ready to go. Brought to you by Gatorade. Let's check out who's on the floor. And so in the game for the Hawks, Millsap at power forward with Horford at center. Teague and Korver in the backcourt, and it's Carroll in at the three set.
And they get on the board first.
Looking to set the tone early.
Teague against Lowry, and Valanciunas kicks to Lowry. Some nice ball movement here by the Raptors. Ross passes to DeRozan. Just five on the clock. And so he draws the foul on the shot, a trip to the line to shoot two.
DeMar DeRozan is starting to piece it together. I mean, we see him up in his scoring average. He's shooting it better. He's passing the ball with more confidence. He's becoming more efficient. You know, after a big extension from the Raptors, I think they've got to be pleased with his progress.
That's good from DeMar DeRozan. And guys, when you look at DeRozan, where can he take the next step?
Well, he has the physical tools to be an elite perimeter defender. He's made strides, definitely, but you know, he has the potential, I think, to be even better than what he is right now.
That's also good. So he hits both free throws.
DeMar DeRozan, a first-time All-Star last year, he improved his long-range shooting. On wing threes, up around 40%, and that allowed him to shoot the best overall three-point percentage of his career.
Here's Carroll. Here is Korver. Puts it up. And that one hits back iron.
And DeRozan last season cracking 30% from long range for the first time in his young, promising career. That outside shot has been the missing part of his offensive game because we know he can get to the rack.
And so it's Atlanta with it. Jonas Valanciunas unable to get his shot to go. Millsap against Ross. Millsap dishes to Carroll. Millsap a screen. Here's Teague. No good off the front iron. We'll talk about DeRozan attacking inside, Steve, last season among the top five in free throws made.
Yeah, 6'7", he's strong, he's athletic, you know, he has the ability to finish in the lane, and I just like the way he's improved as a passer as well, getting his teammates involved.
A good finish at the rack off the swift feet.
Well, they just gave him 2 points. Defensively, you're going to have to tighten things up here. That's not a good sign.
Millsap a screen on Lowe. Over to the left wing. Outside Carroll. That's good. And so Teague with the assist. Carroll's got himself on the board with three there. Raptors have gone 1 of 3 from the field to start this one so far. Kicks it to DeRozan. First quarter of ball, almost 2.5 minutes in. Loses the defender with the screen and drills the jumper. DeRozan's got 6.
He had a whole lot of space to get that shot off.
Yeah, I don't think the defender did a good job there of getting over the top of the screen.
Korver kicks to Teague. Dishes to Korver. And there's the whistle, fouled hard on the shot. He'll go to the line.
Kyle Korver really keeps his defender busy. He's great at running off screens, and you know that's where he gets a lot of his shots. And even when he doesn't get the ball, he occupies the defense, which is so important for his team.
And Korver really trains so that he can sustain that energy moving off the ball.
That's one of the more impressive things about it. Not only his quick release, but the work he does prior to getting loose for those shots. It takes an awful lot of endurance, stamina, and mental toughness, Kevin.
The free throws drop for Korver.
Last season, there were a handful of teams jockeying for that final playoff spot in the East, and the Hawks were right there in the middle of it and ended up snagging the 8th seed and then scared the Pacers in round one.
Both good from the line that time.
And although the Hawks would end up being the only sub-500 team to make the playoffs, they put on quite a show when they got there.
Now here's Ross. Lowry passes to DeRozan. Lowry setting the pick for DeRozan. Ross on the wing. From the baseline. And another basket for Toronto. Well, Atlanta was able to push Indiana to 7 games before falling out of the playoffs. Certainly proved they deserve to be there.
And they did it without being at full strength, Kevin. I mean, Al Horford was out most of the season with that torn pectoral muscle. Just to be able to put up that kind of fight against Indiana, it was a comfortable matchup for the Hawks. Shooting threes, spreading the floor, playing small ball, and they gave Indiana all they wanted and then some.
Toronto with the ball, following the bucket by the Hawks. Lowry kicks to Valanciunas. And he gets it to go. Valanciunas has got his first points of the night. Clark and Steve, this tug-of-war game continues.
You know what? And they just keep flip-flopping the lead again and again and again.
Yeah, how about that last lead change, guys? That's number 7 for the game.
Here is Korver. Back to Teague. Millsap a screen on Lowry. Teague against Lowry. Offensive rebound, Horford, and he banks in the layup.
He got a great read of where that miss was going, and that allowed him to be the first guy to it and get the putback.
The drive by Lowry. Johnson sets the screen for Lowry. Johnson outside. On the wing, DeRozan. And another basket for Toronto.
Well, he's so hard to stop, guys, because he poses a ton of matchup problems for the defense.
Here is Korver. He's guarded by Ross. Korver dishes to Carroll. And there's the pass to Teague. Shot denied. They retain possession. The basket counts and 1. He'll go to the line with a chance to make it a 3-point play.
Raptors foul. Kyle Lowry. That's his first personal foul.
The Hawks have had two chances at the line already, making them both. Free throw drop for Al Horford.
Al Horford, the Dominican big man, won two titles with that great University of Florida team, actually back-to-back titles in 06 and 07. You really love his skill level. There's not much he can't do. He gets up and down, terrific passer, and his mid-range jumper is spot on.
Toronto trailing. We'll go to Doris Burke, who spoke with head coach Dwayne Casey. What's the news, Doris?
We talked about the keys to this game, and he singled out Paul Millsap as a player they've simply got to be mindful of. Coach told me he's always been an energy guy, someone you have to locate and box out every possession. But he's developed his offensive game to the point where he's more than just a hustle guy. He's also a scoring threat now, and a guy we can't leave open. They'll be watching him, Kevin.
Thanks, Doris.
Another nice bucket down low. They've really been able to work the ball into the post effectively so far.
Yeah, I think that could really set things up well the rest of the game. Pound the ball inside and let your perimeter players play off your bigs.
Four of their last five makes came off of a high-quality shot inside.
Yeah, that's textbook basketball, just having their way down low.
Now, here is Lowry. He's been patient so far, nothing yet on the scoreboard. On the wing, Johnson, for the three. Here's Valanciunas. No luck. Good work defensively by Horford. For Atlanta, they've gone 6-12 from the field here in the first quarter. Teague with the ball. Lowry picks him up. Korver passes to Horford. There's the feed to Korver. Shot clock at 6. Launches a 3. Another shot. And Horford lays it up and in. And it's a 4-point Hawks lead.
Just seems like they're finding an open lane to the hoop every time down. That's 5 buckets in a row for them in the paint.
Yeah, on the flip side, Steve, the defenders have to show more fight on the interior.
Lowry kicks to Ross. Pass to Johnson. Feeds it to Ross. Now Lowry. Pass to DeRozan. From outside the arc. That's in, coming off an assist from Lowry. And that's now 11 points for DeMar DeRozan.
Impeccable mechanics this quarter. He's been perfect from the field.
And Atlanta calls their first timeout of the game. A new group in now for the Raptors. Hanslow's checked in for Jonas Valanciunas. Patterson comes in for Johnson. Lou Williams is checked in for Ross. And it's Vasquez in for Kyle Lowry. Outside, Scott to the right side. Here's Antic. And a foul on the shot. He'll go to the stripe for 2.
Pero Antic, nice find for the Atlanta Hawks last season. He signed as a rookie free agent, but he's a veteran with over a decade of professional experience in Europe. Also a captain of the Macedonian national team.
And Clark, talking about Antic, 6'11", 260, plays smart D and can space the floor from three-point range.
Yeah, he shot around 33% from the three-point line last season. If he can keep that up, I think with his size, there's a place for him here in the NBA shooting it like that.
Both free throws good from Antic.
Well, hockey rules supreme here in Canada, but you got to respect these diehard Raptor fans. Even through the losing years, they've shown their support.
Patterson, the screen. Vasquez dishes to Patterson. Outside, Williams. 6 on the shot clock. Right side, Williams. No good with the wing jumper. And the hockey season runs pretty much concurrent to the NBA's, Clark. I think hoop fans in Canada in the past sometimes looked at as eccentrics.
Well, that could be, but the sport is growing, and not only in size, but in popularity. I mean, we've seen some terrific prospects coming out of Canada. If the Raptors can craft a contender, you better believe those folks will be making that arena a madhouse. He's got the firepower, feeling the rhythm here, going 5 for 5 so far.
Yeah, everything seems to be working. He's in a nice groove.
Here's Schroeder. He's been patient so far, nothing yet on the scoreboard. And Bazemore kicks to Schroeder. Pass to Cephalosha. Here's Bazemore. From 13, the shot is off.
You know, that mid-range jump shot is not his strong suit, even when he gets a good look like that.
Hansbro, the pass to Vasquez. Left side, DeRozan with the shot. And there are the Raptors with another bucket.
He shot the ball exceptionally well as they've built this lead for themselves here.
Atlanta's gone 1-2 from long range in the first quarter. The dish to Cephalosha. And no good. Trying to use the glass. Raptors with the lead. Williams kicks to Hansbro. He dishes it to Patterson. He feeds it to Vasquez. Toronto working the ball around now. Patterson setting the pick for DeRozan. He kicks to Vasquez. And again, Toronto with the triple.
It seems that every pass they make is leading to a score here. I mean, that's just exquisite ball movement.
Yeah, they're making the right play, they're working together, and they're just looking for the best shot they can every possession.
Just 1 second between the shot clock and game clock. Kicks to Bazemore. Here's Antic, Hansbro defender. Here's Bazemore. Releases from the wing and drills it.
You know, typically he's just a role player, but when he does score, it allows the offense to be more balanced.
Here's DeRozan. At the end of one, a closely contested game so far. Toronto ahead. They lead by a bucket. And we'll be back in just a moment with the start of the second quarter.
It's a Halloween broadcast of the NBA. LeBron James and the Cleveland Cavaliers take on Derrick Rose and the Chicago Bulls. Friday night, NBA Hoops. Be there.
So far, it's been a closely contested game as we get the second quarter up and going. What do you guys think about the Raptors here in this one?
Just the start they wanted to this game. Solid offense. They got good ball movement. Established a nice rhythm.
Yeah, not stagnant at all. Free-flowing and fluid at the offensive end.
This is how the floor looks for the Hawks starting the second quarter. Dennis Schroeder is out there with Kent Bazemore. Then it's Payne. Then it's Tabo Cephalosha. And it's Antic in at the center.
Tyler Hansbro, known as Psycho T back at North Carolina. Big-time banger. Seeks contact offensively and draws a lot of fouls, too.
At the line from your Raptors. Hansbro, single-minded offensively. And I don't mind that. Hey, you catch the ball in positions, he gets it in to score. Some would even go so far as calling him a black hole, but, you know, last season he was a little more selective, and I think he had his best season yet as far as scoring efficiently.
That one misses.
And Hansbrough, a pretty good post defender. His physicality really serves him well.
And he's improved his rebounding rate the last couple of seasons as well. You know, he's got good mobility for his size, so he keeps himself in the mix for all those loose balls.
Here's Bazemore. Sepulosa dishes to Bazemore. Just five on the clock. No good. Nice D from DeRozan. Raptors leading by three. Stolen by Schroeder. And here's the fast break. Sepulosa leading the way. Dishes it to Schroeder. And the pass to Sepulosa. In the corner, Bazemore with it. Cracks in the tray. Bazemore's got it all tied up now for Atlanta.
Boy, that was a rugged screen set there, fellas, and the defense didn't even try to go through that one.
Vasquez kicks to DeRozan. Loses his man off the screen and lays it up and in. DeRozan's got 17 now. Atlanta's shooting in this game 45%. The feed to Payne. Pass to Bazemore. To the wing on the left. Here's Sepulosa. Money from the wing. Here is Vasquez. Feeds it to DeRozan. Pass to Vasquez. And the shot counts. He's fouled. And it's a chance for a three-point play.
I think they need to get much more disruptive defensively. They can't just keep allowing these easy baskets.
I agree. They need more energy in the post, maybe some double teaming. They've got to get their defense in gear.
A new group in now for the Raptors. Jonas Valanciunas, he's checked in for Hansbrough. Johnson comes in for Patrick Patterson. Ross, he's checked in for DeMar DeRozan. And it's Kyle Lowry in for Lou Williams. And Atlanta will go for a different look here. Paul Millsap's checked in for Barrow Antich. Damari Carroll comes in for Sepulosa. Kyle Korver, he's checked in for Kent Bazemore. And it's Teague in for Dennis Schroeder. Six to shoot. Pass to Carroll. Uncovered. And the Hawks getting another basket right there.
Boy, such outstanding patience and decision-making for them offensively.
Yeah, absolutely. Their ball movement has been outstanding. They are piling up the assists.
Now here's Ross. Johnson sends the screen for Ross. Back to Lowry. Lets it go with a three. No good. So Atlanta will take it the other way. This, of course, their first chance to take a look at this year's Toronto squad.
And this is a big game, guys, today, because these teams will see each other three more times down the road. And this one kind of sets the tone for the season series.
And let's now go to the sideline. We'll catch up here with Doris Burke. Doris?
Hey, Kevin. As you know, Adrian Payne out of the talented Michigan State basketball program. He's one of the older rookies in this draft class, but he only started playing basketball in the eighth grade. He said, quote, "I haven't been playing the game for that long. I got better in a short period of time, and I became a great player. I feel like I have a lot of room to grow." One can only imagine, guys.
That's right, Doris. Thanks. Valanciunas passes to Lowry. Ross for three. Here's Johnson. And that's good. A nice job on the glass as they pick up two on the second effort.
But the defense just looked a little lazy on the glass there.
Yeah, nobody boxing out. That's inexcusable.
I think Steve nailed it moments ago, Clark, talking about, you know, these series of three, four games between these two teams during the year. And eventually, they'll know each other very well. But as we see now, the slate between them is clean.
And being that it is their first meeting, Kevin, I'm actually anxious and curious to see what's changed in terms of how they come at each other compared to last season.
Free throw, good, Teague.
Jeff Teague, one of the quickest and most elusive point guards in the NBA. He's incredible in transition, and where he's really improved is in the half court. He's figured out how to carve up defenses off the dribble.
Al Horford has checked in for Payne. And so Teague gets two free throws. And Teague, a top-tier penetrator, a nice teardrop in the lane.
And he's an improved passer, too, Kevin. I like the confidence he's starting to play with now. Getting into the lane, he's elite when it comes to the assist-turnover ratio.
that point guards are measured by, and he continues to expand his offensive game as well.
For Atlanta, they've gotten four of their first five shots to fall in the second quarter. Outstanding shooting. Millsap down low. Valanciunas is there, and that one's good. Raptors trail by four. Lowry with the ball. No scoring yet from him, but that's likely to change. It's rebounded by T.
That's not an opportunity he fails to convert very often.
And they're going to count the bucket and send him to the line. It could be a three-point play.
I like the way they've picked it up here offensively in the second.
Well, they've really caught fire. Their shooting percentage is in the high 50s now, so they're rolling. A lot of big things happened for Kyle Korver last year, but the one that sticks out in my mind is that he was able to tie and then break the record of 90 consecutive games with a made three-pointer. Says a lot about him as a player, his work ethic, and his consistency.
Now here is Lowry. And here is Vasquez. The dish to Valanciunas. He feeds it to Vasquez. Five on the clock. Here's Lowry. That falls. Great assist by Vasquez. Lowry's got his first points in this one. And for Korver last season, his streak ending at 127 games with a made three. And it was his most efficient season, Clark, as far as his scoring.
Well, he was over 90% at the line, and he hit from everywhere on the floor. I mean, an absolute laser from behind that three-point line. You look at his shot chart, and it's a big field of green, which is made buckets.
Here's Teague. He's got seven. He dishes it to Korver. Back to Teague. He kicks it to Horford. It's stolen by Valanciunas. Lowry with the ball. Picked up by Teague. Johnson with a screen on Teague. Outside Lowry. Clock at six. Let's it go from 11. And yes, sir, that one drops. Lowry's got his second basket.
Whatever their plan was defensively that time, it didn't work. Not if it results in that shot.
T dishes to Korver. Back to T. Kicks it to Carroll. The pass to T. And misses it off the right side of the rim. The drive by Lowry. And another basket for Toronto.
It was a slow start for him, but he started to take off since we hit the second quarter, guys.
Atlanta's gotten both of their three-point attempts to go down here in the second quarter. Millsap a screen. Lowry against T. And he banks in the layup. Teague's got 7 points for the quarter.
Took advantage of some shoddy defense there. They've got to at least get a finger on it.
Now here is Lowry. He has six. Ross with it, and it's Horford picking him up. And a foul called on the shot. Got him on the way up that time, so he'll shoot two right here. Paul Millsap picks one up.
Well, there were a lot of amazing performances last season, but one that I didn't see coming was Terrence Ross notching 51 points early in 2014. That was just out of the blue.
And with Ross and his big point explosion, Clark, the opportunity was there for him. It was after the Rudy Gay trade, mm-hmm. and DeRozan was out at the time.
Yeah, and it showed just why Toronto is so high on Terrence Ross. I mean, he still needs to grow a bit as a player, but anytime you can score 50 or more in an NBA game, you know you've got game.
So he picks up just one from the line that time.
Big step forward in the play of Terrence Ross last year, and you can see why fans are excited about his growth. He has
Talk about putting something extra on it.
That dunk was way over the top.
Close game or not, Clark, you know, he's going to finish firm when he gets the space.
Still, I mean, startling that he'd even try that right now.
And the Raptors call time here. DeMar DeRozan, he's checked in for basket. And so here's Toronto, trailing by four. Lowry kicks to DeRozan. Back to Lowry. Dishes to Ross. The shot's good on the assist by Lowry. 6 points now for Terrence Ross.
That is not enough coverage. Got to do better than that defensively. Basically, no coverage. I mean, defense did not look very good there.
Here's Horford, and the Hawks getting another basket right there.
Smart. Use that big height advantage. Get the shot off.
Well, it's hard to put a big man on him, Steve, that far from the hoop. I mean, he's versatile.
Ross passes to Lowry. There's the screen. There's the feet to Valanciunas. Johnson inside, defended by Scott. Johnson's shot is off.
You know, not only is the game neck and neck and tight, but the rebounding battle is too. Extremely close on the boards.
Yeah, both teams have really put in a terrific effort down low.
Out to the wing. Here is Korver. He's guarded by Ross. That's good from Horford on the assist by Korver. Korver's got his third assist on the night.
Boy, it's no wonder they've got the lead. Their shooting has really picked up here in the second quarter.
You know, you don't expect the team, Steve, to shoot in the 60% range the entire game. But if they can hover around that mark, then they'll run away with this one.
He still has not missed a shot. Where would they be without him?
And let's catch up with our sideline reporter, Doris Burke. Doris, over to you.
Well, guys, head coach Dwayne Casey has overseen a surprising turnaround in Toronto. Their record has improved in all three seasons under his tenure. DeMar DeRozan said, since I've been here, he preaches the same thing. He told us to stick with it, and it worked. Everything came together like he said it would. Gentlemen.
Pound the rock. The team motto. They put in the work and stayed consistent. Thanks, Doris. Johnson the screen. And DeRozan kicks to Lowry. And again, Toronto with the triple.
Now he's finally starting to get it going here offensively.
Atlanta's gone 3 of 4 from long range in the game. Teague against Lowry. Scott dishes to Kira. Horford with a screen on DeRozan. Pass to Korver. Shot clock at 6. He's looking for Horford and finds him. That's good. Horford's got 17 now.
What a job he's doing here. I mean, his second quarter has been even better than his first, and that was pretty good.
Down low, out of bounds, Atlanta will take possession.
I tell you what, that's just a major unforced error right there, guys. My goodness.
Seconds left to play here in the second quarter. Here's Bazemore. That misses. Would have counted had it gone in. And the first half ends in a close one. Hawks lead by 4. And time now to go courtside as we send you over to Doris Burke from the sideline. Doris?
Thank you, Kevin and Dwayne. A very tight game here. What's the number one thing you need to do in the second half to try to get out ahead and break this thing open?
Well, number one is we got to make sure we get in a defensive disposition. You know, right now we're kind of trading buckets. We're anticipating, putting them on the foul line. So we got to play from an anticipatory style of defense, whereas we're not reacting to where they have us on our heels.
Coach, thanks for the time. Gentlemen, back to you.
Thank you so much, Doris. Great interview as always. Don't go anywhere, folks. We'll be back with the second half of basketball shortly. Raptors trail by four.
You have to give the Hawks a lot of credit for what they did last season. They knew they were going to lose some players and have to hit the reset button and recalibrate a bit, but they did so quite smoothly.
Lowry and Ross pairing up in the backcourt. Amir Johnson at the four with Valanciunas at the pivot. And it's DeRozan in at the three. So that's the five in the game for Toronto. Horford with the screen on Lowry. Carroll passes to Teague. Nice ball movement here by Atlanta. Carroll kicks to Korver. Six to shoot. Feeds to Carroll. Passes it to Korver. There's the bucket. Good. Korver's got nine. Well, for the Hawks, it's been 2 years of big names like Joe Johnson and Josh Smith leaving. Steve, they still remain competitive.
Well, they always seem to have a backup plan in place for whenever a star player leaves. And really, this has been the plan all along, the foresight to create space and picks and cap room. They're trying to build something special here. And, of course, it takes time.
DeRozan, and again it's Toronto converting.
And he's made the most of his chances, hasn't he? He really needs to continue to work for those good looks.
Outside Teague. Horford sets a screen for Teague. Right side Teague. Carroll for three. Toronto grabs the miss. Just over a minute and a half have passed here in the third quarter. Now Lowry. 9 points in the game so far. And the jam by Ross.
You can see the eye contact there. Gave a little nod and then burst to the rim for the alley-oop slam.
No doubt, Clark. A pair of teammates with a terrific feel for each other out on the floor.
And what a play to make in a close game. A potential momentum builder.
Horford high post. Valanciunas is there. Korver dishes to Teague. Outside Carroll. Rebounded by Valanciunas. Valanciunas has got four rebounds now tonight. Guys, we've seen some excellent offensive output.
Yes, sir, fellas. They've had it going on big time.
Big time is right, Clark. A lot of momentum here offensively.
Teague with the ball. He's got nine. Pass to Horford. Back to Teague. Puts it up. And once again off the mark by Atlanta.
And they've been off target now on three of the first four shots they've taken in this second half.
Uses the glass to finish the layup. 23 points for DeMar DeRozan.
This is some kind of performance we're seeing from him today. He has yet to miss a shot.
And here is Teague. The dish to Millsap. He feeds it to Korver. Buries it from three-point range. Korver's got 5 points in the quarter. And Clark and Steve, as we approach the fourth quarter, still anyone's ballgame.
Yeah, exactly right, Kevin. I mean, these teams just simply keep trading baskets and, as a result, trading the lead.
Yeah, neither side really able to create much of a cushion at all. So, you know, which team can make a little run here? We'll see.
DeRozan's shot is good.
They're rolling now. Five straight hoops to start this quarter.
Atlanta calls timeout. Raptors, the city of Toronto, is up to host the All-Star Game in 2016. Toronto has already contributed $500,000 to help host the event.
Well, you know, the city is one of the great cities in the world. And they're excited. That city's excited to showcase itself as an entertainment destination. And for the NBA, a chance to make further inroads in the hockey-obsessed country of Canada.
In the third quarter with just over 3.5 minutes off the clock. Teague, the pass to Horford. He dishes it to Korver. He kicks to Carroll. Down low. Outside Teague. Now the pass to Korver. Four on the shot clock. Here's the floater. Toronto grabs the miss. Johnson's got his fifth rebound right now in the game.
And along with the All-Star game, the Raptors looking forward to a rebrand next season. New colors. Considered blue and white like the short-lived professional team of Toronto Huskies. Black and gold in other directions.
T kicks to Horford.
Wow. Oh, yeah. Look at that athletic play. Incredible.
Wow. Stupendous rush to the rim and a mighty slam on the end of it.
But through the teeth of some pretty soft D, I can't help but say that.
Well, let's see how that impacts things here. Because those kinds of plays sometimes can be game changers on both sides.
Toronto calls timeout. And as with any timeout at this point of the game, important to go over the strategies that are working and those that are needed in terms of adjustments. And, of course, the opportunity, guys, to get hydrated with Gatorade before coming back out on the floor. We've seen some good action so far, and there's more of it to come.
Yeah, this game has been physical. It's been fast. It's been high-paced. So anytime you're in a situation like this where it's really a hard-fought game, critical to keep yourself hydrated throughout.
Atlanta's gotten a success rate of just over 50% from three-point tonight. 4 of 7 shooting.
Intelligent passing there to make that hoop possible.
Raptors trail by 3. Here's Ross. Horford with the rebound. Horford's got 9 rebounds in the game. Getting it done. Kicks to Carroll. Dishes to Horford. Knocked loose and taken away by Johnson. 16 feet away. DeRozan's shot is good. DeRozan's got 8 points in the quarter. Hawks have gone an even 50% to the floor here in the third quarter. 4 of 8. Outside tee. Here's Millsap. And again, it's Atlanta. Raptors have gone 6 of 9 from the floor here in the second half. They've got to be happy with that. Lowry has the open look. The offensive rebound. Valenciunas. And at last, they get one to fall. Valenciunas has got 8.
That's the kind of aggressive and assertive play they need as we get closer and closer to crunch time.
No question. Pound it into the painted area and continue to put pressure on that defense.
Korver dishes to Horford. Here is Korver. He's got 12. Shot clock at 6. And the whistle blows. It's going to be on Amir Johnson. That's his first foul. And Toronto will go for a different look here. Hansbrough's checked in for Jonas Valanciunas. Patterson comes in for Johnson. Lou Williams has checked in for Terrence Ross. And it's Vasquez in for Kyle Lowry. And then for Atlanta, Perel Antic, he's checked in for Horford. Cephalosha comes in for Damari Carroll, and it's Kent Bazemore in for Kyle Korver. Millsap attacking.
Paul Millsap, a first-time All-Star in 2014, really helped the Hawks not miss Josh Smith that much. He gave them superior production at two-thirds the price, and for value-conscious general managers, that's a big win.
And a chance to catch up on some numbers here. Scoring breakdown for Atlanta.
Well, the great passing we saw in the first half has carried right over into the second.
Another thing they've done tonight is work the ball into the paint for plenty of those close-range points. You got to have those.
So he comes up empty at the line. Toronto's gone 0-2 from deep to start things here in the second half. Williams passes to Patterson. It's good. Great play by Williams to set it up. Patterson's got himself on the board with three there.
And Millsap, one of the great value signings last season. Louisiana native, staying closer to home by playing in Atlanta. He really anchored the Hawks' front court as they weathered a bunch of injuries.
T kicks to Cephalosha. Back to T. Nice ball movement here by Atlanta. They get it back. Yes! And the foul. That's on Patrick Patterson.
He's a grinder. Love what he does under the offensive boards. Really bringing energy and life to his team.
Schroeder is checked in for Jeff T. For Atlanta, they have made their free throws at a pretty good clip. They've hit 8 of 10.
About a year ago, they converted about 78% of their free throws as a team, so pretty solid there.
Yeah, they had the kind of success from the line that would make any coach breathe a sigh of relief, guys.
And Paul Millsap last season, for the first time, Clark, making the three-pointer a consistent part of his offensive game.
And it really expanded his game. We knew he was a terrific rebounder. You knew he could bang and score in close. But he added that three-point shot. In addition to a nice little mid-range face-up game, now you got a guy who can be a nightmare to defend.
Here's Schroeder. No scoring yet from him, but that's likely to change. The shot is off. Toronto's gone 1-3 from downtown since halftime. There's a screen by Hansbrough. On the wing, Williams. Off the pick. And the Raptors tack on two more.
And he came off that screen. The defense just couldn't get over the top. Beautiful play.
Yep, and without a hand in his face, he's going to bury those.
Here's Schroeder, and there's the feed to Millsap. Hits the jump hook. Millsap's got seven now in this quarter.
Dennis Schroeder.
1:57 left in the third. Now here's Vasquez. He has six. Williams dishes to DeRozan. Williams attacking. Out to DeRozan. Just five to shoot. Off the mark there with the three-point shot.
Well, he did have a three-pointer in the first half, but so far here in the second, he's come up empty.
Here's Schroeder, guarded by Vasquez. Millsap a screen. Schroeder passes to Millsap. Gets to the rim for two with the D all over him. Millsap's got 9 points now in just the second half. Toronto's gone to the three-pointer 11 times tonight, nailed five of them. There's a screen by Hansbrough. Vasquez kicks to Hansbrough. There's 57 seconds left to play here in the third. Pass to DeRozan. No one near him. And there are the Raptors with another bucket.
You know, he's showing some kind of a killer instinct this quarter, trying to stretch this lead out.
Millsap a screen on Hansbrough. Schroeder dishes to Millsap. And stolen by Patterson. Williams kicks to DeRozan. Bazemore grabs the miss.
Terrific job that time defending at the rim. I mean, it's not an easy task stopping that fella when he's headed to the bucket like that. Good job.
Feeds it to Schroeder. Passes to Cephalosha. His first shot coming late. And it's Schroeder missing.
Well, that's an excellent challenge right there. Good job contesting that shot by the defender.
Well, at least the defender got his money's worth on that one.
Yep, that was an easy whistle for the official.
The Raptors have gone 5 of 7 from the free throw line in the game.
At the line for two.
Free throw good, Vasquez. So both teams making some changes here. And Vasquez drops them both.
There's not a lot you can say that hasn't been said before about his skill at the charity stripe.
Here's Bazemore. No luck. We're at the end of the third, and we've still got a close one. The Raptors out in front, leading by three. And don't go away. We'll be back momentarily.
Bring your costume. It's Halloween in the NBA. Tim Duncan and the San Antonio Spurs take on Goran Dragic and the Phoenix Suns. It's Western Conference action. Be there.
Trail by three. Fourth quarter on the court for the Hawks. Teague and Korver in the backcourt. Payne out there with Mike Scott. And it's Cephalosha in at the three, the small forward. Lifts a mark, and he gets the bucket. And that's 11 points for Teague.
What a great battle these teams are waging today.
Yeah, you get the feeling, Steve. The game could swing on just one or two plays down the stretch.
Now Lowry, and DeRozan kicks to Patterson. Great pass to set up the lay-in. And the Raptors lead by three.
Well, they were sleeping on defense. The defense really didn't do its job. I mean, a little slow to react to the ball getting into the paint, that's costly.
Well, and at this stage of such a tight game, I think this is when tired legs start to show. And the defense can become vulnerable in the low block.
And here's Cephalosha for three. They get it back. Scott, and the rejection by Valanciunas. We've played just over 1 minute here in the fourth quarter. Patterson's in the pick for Lowry. To the paint. Rebounded by Korver. The Hawks trail by three. They need a good offensive possession.
Yeah, they've had a number of empty ones, a long time without a basket.
I gotta find something, you're right. Now, here is Cephalosha. DeRozan defending. Clock at six. Here's Korver. No luck. And it's the Raptors taking it the other way. When this game is done, they'll be off to Orlando and they'll take on the Magic. That'll be the first half of a two-game trip. Left side, DeRozan. Lets it go with a three. Here's Valanciunas. Rebound, Atlanta.
And he continues to search for his rhythm. It's eluded him to this point.
And Toronto making a change here. Johnson's checked in. And then for Atlanta, Horford comes in for Scott. And Damari Carroll subbed in for Thabo Cephalosha. And we're around 2 minutes into the fourth quarter here. Lowry passes to Ross. Johnson the screen. Cross. That's good.
So the pick worked really well there. Nice job taking it right to the 10 for the layup.
The Hawks trail by five. Outside T. Horford with the screen on Lowry. T dishes to Korver. Six to shoot. To the right side. perfect on the shot, swishes it through.
Guys, he shot a very good percentage today, and they've needed it.
Raptors leading by three. Around 3 minutes gone here in the fourth quarter. Valanciunas with the ball. Back to Lowry. Shoots from 14. Great D that time from T. Hawks have gone 2 for 5 on field goal attempts in the fourth quarter. Korver kicks to T. Pass to Payne. The dish to Korver. He feeds it to Carroll. The pass to Horford. Finds the open look, and it's on target. And now just a one-point Raptor lead.
The easiest way to do it sometimes is with the bounce pass.
Kicks it to Ross. Out of bounds, Atlanta takes possession.
Where was he going with that pass? I mean, that's just an awful turnover.
Atlanta making a switch here. Millsap's checked in. Fourth quarter of play, and over 3.5 minutes have gone by. Teague, the pass to Millsap. To take the lead. No good. Johnson with the defensive effort. Toronto's gotten a lot of looks from outside tonight. 5 of 12. And here's Lowry. So he draws the foul on the shot, a trip to the line to shoot two.
Kyle Lowry, an unrestricted free agent this offseason. Last year playing really well in a contract year. Question is, can he maintain that level of play now with this new deal?
Free throw drops for Kyle Lowry. And Lowry, one of the more underrated players in the NBA, but he's also gotten into it with coaches in the past too, Clark.
Yeah, you know, some locker room concerns, he can rub folks the wrong way, but I tend to always want to give the player the benefit of the doubt in this situation until you know for sure what the issues are. Nothing wrong with a little sandpaper coming from a player that's out there competing.
And Kyle Lowry drops them both.
A career best performance from Kyle Lowry last season, posting best in scoring and assist. A lot of people felt like he was the player most egregiously overlooked when it came to the All-Star game.
T kicks to Millsap. And it's going to be two free throws. Drew contact on the shot. And Lowry, arguably the Raptors' best player last season. Despite that, Steve, he was the subject of repeated trade rumors.
Well, it was such a curious situation for Toronto. On one hand, you know, they were trying to rebuild at the beginning of the season, maybe get a top draft pick, and then all of a sudden they started playing well. In the end, no trade. You know, Lowry becomes their best player, and then, you know, he leads them to a top three seed in the playoffs. So it's kind of a strange season.
Paul Millsap, not the biggest or the most athletic, but he just finds ways to get it done.
Yeah, he's so well-rounded. You know, he does the big things and the little things to help you win. He's a good passer. He moves without the ball, keeps your offense flowing, and then, of course, really developed that three-point shot last year, which made him an effective stretch four.
And Millsap has always had a terrific motor. He combines his elite talent level with tremendous effort and toughness. I think those things are a big key to his personal success, which helps his teams be successful, too.
And the Raptors call time here.
Well, you talk about Millsap's motor, gets you extra possessions, draws fouls, makes his free throws. A great player, finally getting his due.
Doris Burke has an update for us. Doris?
During that break, Dwayne Casey had some words for his team. He tried to really fire them up to bring it home, saying, "All night, you have all night to rest after the final buzzer. For now, we have to lay it on the line and try to bring it home." Guys, back to you.
And he gets it to go. 32 points for DeMar DeRozan.
This guy will really make you pay if you leave him enough room outside.
Outside T, Horford with a screen on Lowry. Shoots from 12. Second shot opportunity, and there's the play inside by Millsap. Millsap's got 4 points this quarter.
Well, he's having a great half here. Exactly the opposite of the first.
Lowry dishes to DeRozan. Lowry setting the pick for DeRozan. And Valanciunas kicks to Lowry. The feed now to Valanciunas. Clock at six. The shot's good on the assist by Lowry. Lowry's got his sixth assist on the night.
And now both of these clubs really in a groove here.
Already a high-scoring game, but it has become an offensive showcase down the stretch.
Dishes to Millsap, 6 feet out. And a foul on the shot. He'll go to the stripe for two.
Well, Paul Millsap has been getting it done. 15 points, and he's contributed 3 points from the line, too.
Yeah, those are always easy points. I mean, when you can get to the line and knock them down, sometimes that's the difference in the game, Clark.
And a chance for just a second to check out the scoring breakdown for the Raptors.
I thought maybe they'd cool off a bit at halftime, but they've just continued to shoot well.
Something we've also seen them doing tonight is getting the long ball to go down. Big points from outside. He's done a much better job of getting to the line here, aggressively taking it inside and not shying away from contact. I thought he was settling a bit in the first.
That one misses.
For the first time in a long time, it seems that the Raptors have a clear vision of where they are headed and are on the right track, and it helps when you know where you're going. You can definitely feel a sense of hopefulness and optimism around on this team and among the fans.
Well, if you were to say the Raptors weren't good before last year, that's not the case at all. They just seem to be stuck where they were.
Yeah, and often in the NBA, it's a lot worse to be stuck in a place than it is to be bad. You don't have a chance to bounce forward if you're stuck. When you're bad, you do get a chance to improve through the draft. And last year, the Raptors improved, and they've got a bright future.
Free throw drops for Lowry.
Well, to get those big in-conference wins, you've got to be able to adjust mid-game, and the Hawks did that very well last season. A lot of runs for them in the third quarter of games.
Lowry drops them both. And for the Hawks in the East, guys, finished as the eighth seed in part because of their ability to adjust after the half.
Yeah, they'd end up with 28 wins in the conference, but a lot of them came from their ability to come out strong after the break.
Time call here. The Hawks decide to talk it over. The Hawks trail by six. Outside Teague. Good on the 13-footer. Here's Lowry. He dishes it to DeRozan. Johnson sets the screen for DeRozan. Johnson kicks to Lowry. And stolen by Jeff T. Into Al Horford. And lots of contact there. Missing the shot. He'll shoot two.
Horford having just a fantastic game. He has 9 rebounds and a steal. Seems like he's making everything he looks at.
Automatic, guys. Just completely automatic at this point. Al Horford, 6'10", 250. Really a natural power forward who's been asked to play at center for his whole career. He's shown himself willing to battle bigger players inside, but you got to think he'd welcome a chance to switch back to the four spot.
And for Horford, you know, able to scrap inside to overcome his lack of size defensively, his quickness is his biggest advantage. I mean, he's excellent at moving in space and defending the pick and roll.
On the second free throw. You guys are talking about Horford's advantages playing center. Certainly his offensive skill set among those advantages.
Yeah, and an excellent mid-range jump shooter and ball handler. Face up, draw opposing bigs further out than they'd like. but he's also strong enough and quick enough to get past them and get to the rim.
Here's T. T left side. He kicks to Millsap. Shot clock at six. Goes back up. And it's Toronto with the rebound. Johnson's got his seventh rebound of the game with that last one.
Great job. Taking it right at the defense. I like the aggressiveness.
Yeah, he left them no choice but to foul there.
Amir Johnson is one of the longest tenured Toronto Raptors in his sixth season with the team now. And with the departures of Bargnani and Ed Davis, he's assumed a starting role, and I think he's responded quite well to it.
He's off on the first. And Amir Johnson has said he wants to play the rest of his career, Steve, in Toronto.
Well, he's really embraced the community, connected with the fans. And, you know, for people who haven't been to Toronto, they don't know what they're missing. It's a wonderful city, and the support that the Raptors get is just awesome. I mean, they fill up the building. They even fill up the park right outside the building to watch the games during the playoffs. It's awesome.
And the second free throw, good.
The Atlanta Hawks with relatively new leadership in the front office, and the team is going in more of an analytic direction. Head coach Mike Budenholzer from his time in San Antonio, certainly well-versed in that approach as well.
Outside DeRozan. Valanciunas passes to DeRozan. And the layup's good off the glass. DeRozan's got the lead up to six now for Toronto.
And look at this new direction for the Hawks. They're definitely fond of elite shooters to space the floor, and they've looked for players who can defend the pick and roll. So a commitment to high efficiency offense and denying that type of offense by the other team is really what you see this team trying to build towards. And Mike Budenholzer, their coach, comes from the San Antonio Spurs way of playing and thinking, and you can start to see some of that imprint on this Hawks team.
And Stevie talked about forcements. With Horford gone, the Hawks played 5 3-point shooters in their starting lineup.
And that matchup gave the Pacers all kinds of trouble in the playoffs. And the Hawks took them to 7 games despite their vastly different records over the regular season.
He's good on the second. Toronto leading by 5. Johnson with a screen on Teague. Lowry dishes to DeRozan. Trying to find Valanciunas. Gets it to him. Foul call that time on the way up. That'll give him 2 chances at the free throw line here.
Atlanta needs to do a better job guarding against Valanciunas.
11 rebounds and 2 rejections. Excellent defensive presence on the glass. And delivering some of that shot blocking skill, too.
Yeah, a dominant performance in the paint.
And the first one at the line is good.
Look at the free throw percentage. Unblemished since halftime, Clark. That's pretty nice.
I'd go farther than that, Steve. How about perfect?
And so he makes both from the line. The Hawks trail by 7. T gets to Korver. The Hawks again can't hit.
A slight advantage for them in the rebound category. They've got to continue their work on the glass.
Yeah, I agree with you, Steve. I mean, they're on the right side of the ledger, and that is all that matters to them right now with the lead they have.
There's 1:38 left in the fourth quarter. Ross with the steal. And here's the fast break. Ross leading the way. hammers it in after taking it the length of the floor.
Boy, how's that for a quick possession?
Yeah, it sure was. I mean, he didn't waste any time getting down the court, did he?
Time call here. The Hawks decide to talk it over. They're behind by 9. 1:31 left to play in the final quarter. Outside Teague. Here's Horford. Hits the difficult fadeaway jumper. Horford's got 25 points in the game.
It's a good thing he showed up today, because without him, this team would be in big trouble.
Johnson sets the screen for Lowry. Pass to Johnson. Feeds it to DeRozan. Johnson the screen, and DeRozan. Here we go. The timely screen. Getting a step, and he took it all the way. DeRozan's got 17 points here in the second half. The Hawks trail by 9. Carroll for 3. That drops.
A wide open 3. They need much better communication defensively.
The Raptors have gone 8-13 from the field since the start of the fourth, sinking the majority of their shots. Here's DeRozan. The shot no good. Great D that time from Teague. Atlanta's gotten just 1 of 4 three-pointers to go down for them here in the fourth. Passes it to Horford. Foul call that time on the way up. That'll give him 2 chances at the free throw line here. As he doesn't get the first one to fall, trying to focus now on the second. And he ends up making the second, and that brings them within 5.
I'm sure he'd like that miss back. Hard to chip away at a lead when you're leaving points at the line.
A chance here to possibly put it out of reach.
Now they've got to focus, make sure this is a good, solid possession. They can take control of this game.
It's DeRozan with the drive. That falls. Nice feed that time from Kyle Lowry. DeRozan's got 38 points.
This game's over, guys. I think we can say that with certainty.
Yeah, I agree with you there. We have officially reached garbage time.
Atlanta calls timeout. They're losing by 7. 20 seconds left in the fourth quarter. What do you think, guys?
Well, this one's out of reach, so I'm not sure why they're calling the timeout here. Maybe just to try to work on something, maybe an out-of-bounds play or something.
Well, they might as well talk about what movies they want to see or what they want to surf on the internet, because this one's done, boys.
And the Raptors going out now with a whole new group. Now here's Williams. And so it's Toronto winning this one. Both teams played well, but these guys had the edge.
Yeah, I think so. They were just steak knife sharp. Very on top of their game here.
Well said. And a chance now to send you over to Doris Burke, standing by on the sideline. Doris?
Thank you, Kevin. Kyle, you were able to impact this game on both sides of the ball, making some nice passes, playing good defense. How did you feel about your game?
I just want to stop the basket, you know. I want to do anything it takes to win, you know, help my team win. You know, tonight, you know, was passing the ball. Not, my shot wasn't falling, but, you know, I had too many turnovers, but I passed the ball well, and we got the win. That's all that matters.
Kyle, thank you. Kevin, it's not only about the offense.
Thank you, Doris, for that. And now for Clark Kellogg, Steve Kerr, and Doris Burke. This is Kevin Harlan saying, see you next time, as we present our Jordan Player of the Game, DeMar DeRozan.